Greetings, dear Squidlings. Have you ever experienced the following? You are having an extremely intellectual discussion on twitter.com on the nature of fungi. Your partner in conversation makes a claim that seems interesting, but you want to engage in some healthy skepticism. You ask for a citation. The individual provides a link to a paper. You click the link and the summary seems to agree with the person's claims. You want to check the methodology of the study at fucking paywall! I mean, what really happened was you tried to argue with an anti-vaxxer against your better judgment and found that it took you ages to find a paper that wasn't paywalled, but the result was still the same. I feel for you, we've all done it. Instead, I recommend either evaluating their humours, sending them a random picture of a leech, or starting an extremely pointless argument about some minor. And then there are those websites that tell you that by filling in surveys you can get money. Sounds like a cool idea until you realise they're not paying you real money, they're giving you points. Presumably because if they gave you real money, they'd have to pay you minimum wage or something. Look at this nonsense. 55,000 points gets you a £10 gift card, which by my maths makes 55 points equal to 1 penny. According to this, a 10-minute survey can get you 1,200 points, so theoretically you can get 7,200 points an hour. 7,200 divided by 55 is 130.9. They pay you up to £1.30 an hour in a best case scenario, and they probably don't even have to reward that because the moment people realise this is nonsense, they stop doing this, so they never get enough points to get a gift card. I hope the data they get is of the lowest quality possible because they are shite birds. And some of those surveys are super sketchy. Agreeing to do those surveys would inflict more miasma on my computer than clicking those adverts on dodgy sites asking me if I want to do sex with some stock photos of Russian ladies. And like I said before, if you want some information, you better hope it's not paywalled or hidden behind 20,000 layers of PR doublespeak. So, information is simultaneously so valuable that entire companies make their money off selling it, but worth so little that any you sell is not even worth £2 an hour. And that's not even getting into the fucking surveillance cameras everywhere. I'm sure whoever watches those things is fascinated by watching someone trip over a step on their way to their favourite milkshake place. And this gross invasion of privacy is justified because what if a racist statue gets covered in the milkshake they bought? That's not even nearly as exciting as the job of the cop who gets to watch the security cameras in police cells. They get a direct view of a random person going to the loo. I can tell you from personal experience that the camera in police cells is pointed directly at the toilet. This is why all cops are bad. Any person working for an organisation that thinks pointing a camera where someone has to pee. Of course, there are other things I could discuss. Tuition fees. The assumption that the only reason you might want to learn is so that you can impress a potential employer. Systemic bigotry leading to the knowledge being created or discovered, having a very white, cis-abled male perspective. Note to neuroscientists, stop doing research about prenatal autistic development for vaguely eugenics-y reasons and start actually trying to help us. YouTube algorithms promoting racist misinformation constantly. Broadly speaking, what this leads to is a distribution of knowledge up the social and economic hierarchy. Corporate creeps and government people get all the juicy knowledge they want and then could use that information to send you adverts for weed despite it being illegal in your country, or to ignore the fact we really need to keep coal in the ground or the world will end. Meanwhile, if you want to read about, for example, pterosaur pycnofibers, you will get told that you have to pay an arbitrary sum of money, and according to the actual science people, that money does not even go to them, it goes to the publisher, so the people that find this knowledge aren't even properly compensated for it. So, what do we do about it? Well, there are two sides to this. One, stopping companies and the state from collecting data about you. The second is absorbing as much knowledge into you and your friends as possible. First of all, wear a mask. Given the ubiquity of CCTV cameras and the fact that COVID is a thing, you should be wearing a mask in public. Protect your rights and others' health in one. Secondly, protect your digital privacy. Avoid browsers that are based on Chromium, as this tracks your browsing history, for example Chrome and Microsoft Edge. I'd recommend either Firefox or Tor. Finally, go to your social media accounts and disable as many personalization settings as you can, because that information is being sold to advertisers, because it is creepy how much social media accounts know about you. Now for the fun one, learning. There are plenty of free places to learn, your local library, archive.org, which is cool. As for getting round paywalls, you can email the author of any given paper and they will often give you a free copy. Many authors also upload their papers to ResearchGate. What I would never recommend is using piracy sites like Sci-Hub or LibGen that give free copies of many papers that they acquired super illegally, because that would be crimes. And I know you hate hearing this, but try not to spread misinformation. Consider what sources you retweet. But, more broadly, we do have to think about the redistribution of access to knowledge. Right now, access to scientific papers is heavily gatekept by money and willingness to deal with academic culture, which is easier if you're white, male, abled, etc. I personally have been delayed significantly in my academic development via my void powers making me tired all the time when I'm in the realm of the flesh, making it very difficult for me to gain that qualifications that mean universities will let me in. And there are even simpler things that can be done. Audio or braille copies of text, having stuff in large print, wheelchair access, etc. In my Learning Chaos video, I described how power dictates what you learn. That is true here too, in addition to the added constraints of adult life also dictating who can learn. So, what we need is a liberation of knowledge away from formal academia. Academia might have its place for intensive study, but everyone should have access to the ability to learn and improve themselves. Libraries and archives, both digital and physical, are important, as well as things like makerspaces, where people are free to teach each other skills organically without the prior approval of an authority. But, in the meantime, try to learn as much accurate information as you can. No one can take knowledge away from you. Learn about plants, fungi, history, physics, chemistry, folklore, whatever. And native English speakers, try to learn a second language. Colonialism made everyone have to learn our Frankenstein mess of a language. We owe it to the rest of the world to at least try to speak someone else's. Oh, and donate to archive.org. They got dicked over by copyright trolls a while ago, and no one wants to lose the Wayback Machine.